I have a question. Like, still we are having education system based on Western civilization. Like, in our education system, why can't we have a course like that, doing some social service, or doing a course following their respective faiths, like someone following Bhagavad Gita, having that course, someone having following Christianity, Muslim, respective faiths, and at the same time, still further, in corporate sector also, they pay money and they generate income. And why don't they give some hours for these kind of courses and social services? And you are all the top guns at the top level. Like, the power is in your hands. Why can't such policies come out? And even farmers also get help. Why isn't
integrating social science into our curriculum and our Indian Institute of Science itself? This has been done now in the new undergraduate program that we have started, because it's very difficult to, you know, direct or misdirect an older person who's coming for research. So we have now started introducing a lot of social science curriculum in the undergraduate course, which was started last year.
Good evening, Professor Ghosh. You want to say anything?
I want to point out to CC, his specific question was that, are we bringing the Indian values, actually? That is what I think specifically asked. And my observation is, what I'm observing, that we have the humanities and social sciences. In fact, the IIT system was started to, I mean, as in contrast to other engineering college, to have some more social component when Jawaharlal Nehru started it. But it is my observation that the role of our Indian assets are a little less. But in contrary, I will try to tell you another thing. See, this ISC and IIT, they are not the only educational systems. Like, for example, Bhaktivedanta Institute is there. So you can come to Bhaktivedanta Institute for actually learning about our Vedic scriptures and other things.
But the route to Bhaktivedanta Institute is to come through IIT Kanpur, IIT Kharagpur, IIT Guwahati, Delhi Technological University, Indian Institute of Science. This is what exactly it is. So really, I think you are our role models. You can't deny. What sir is trying to say, that although the space has been created for social sciences and humanities, not enough respect has been shown to India's profound wisdom, which was the basis for development of education, which will serve the need for knowledge, need for character, and need for the conduct and behavior of the people who are knowledgeable. Today, the need is much more than ever before, because we are in a new knowledge society. Professor Balasubramanian already alerted you. Now, the question why? Would you move away from money, it's so funny in the rich man's world, in your corporate world, or you will keep on beating the drum of money, sir? Chandraji would answer this.
I think it's a very valid point what you've raised, but you know, the multinational companies are quite cognizant of that over the years. You might have seen, starting with the erstwhile Rockefeller Foundation and the Carnegie Foundation and some of these large philanthropists, and today you have Warren Buffett and several others along with Bill Gates who have started giving back charity. That's on one aspect. But they look at areas which are more horizontal in some sense, which are scalable and which can be done, which is religion agnostic. And companies also do this, corporate social responsibility, which today even in India, many companies have taken it up. And I think there was a talk to introduce some kind of tax benefit and bills and so on. I don't know where the latest on that is in the Indian context. But I think some of these companies are focused based on their religious aspirations, at least in the Indian context, and their comfort. If not at a corporate level, on a personal level, they're able to contribute to that. But on a religious platform, I'm not very sure about anybody giving funding directly for a religious organization. You have Aga Khan Foundation, you have some specific cases, but are not on a very wide scale.
But the answer we were looking for, that if I am the corporate chief, CM, owner of a particular corporation, if I make billions of dollars as profit this year, I would rather reduce my cost so that my profit comes down and the benefit goes directly to the people, rather than putting up that cost further and maximize my profit further, and then portion of it goes to my green dollars or charitable investment. So we are looking for corporates which would disseminate the benefit of their organizational excellence and organizational productivity back to the people, so that ultimately let what matters at the end of the day, whether I get it cheaper or more expensive. This is, I think, pinching people today because of mehngai and all this. Any answer quickly before we close the session, because I have to catch my flight before they leave me here.
I think I just wanted to say that since we are sitting here in IISc, I think several of you should be cognizant that this was all given out of funding from the Tata Trust and from the Tata family. So that's one data point I wanted to just emphasize on. I'm sure, Professor. Okay.
No. Don't confuse, because partial information could be dangerous.
So, you know, I didn't want to get into a debate of any kind. I think it's nice not to, I don't talk about Microsoft, so he should talk about the Indian Institute of Science.
I think the context in which we are looking at corporates of tomorrow to be far more responsive to the society, to understand that the society is behind creation of these corporates, and that affinity and atmita between corporate and people is the need of the hour.